John took my music away. Hi, how are you guys doing today? I am Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa. On the mic today is my husband, John.
Hi, guys.
He is the voice that follows you guys around with cameras and tracks me and reads comments and makes sure that our live events go really well. In case you're here for the first time on a replay, we actually record these live.
Mm-hmm.
So you never know what's going to happen. If you're here for the live, you kind of already know that. I want to say thank you to our moderators and everybody who has shown up today. I'm really excited. Today we're going to teach you guys how to do this really awesome road trip inspired Desert Sunset. I just recently took a trip and we did a road trip from Texas to California, and I just got completely reacquainted with how much I love a desert sunset. My kids were like, through the whole trip going, can you paint that?
Uh-huh.
Can you paint that? can you paint that? I'm like, I paint all of it.
And then I asked for a fair number of paintings too.
You asked for what?
There was a bunch of paintings I liked too. Yeah, I was like, ooh, I like, actually this one. I liked this one quite a lot. This when we saw all of these cactus, I was like, ooh, I like that.
Yeah, I like seeing the saguaros. I love the Joshua trees. So you guys will be seeing this ongoing. Dawns, sunsets, crazy colored skies, everything you can think of. And today has a special twist, neon paints.
Ooh.
We're going to talk about, yes, of course, we're going to show you black light at the end. But we're going to talk about the act of just actually using neons to get vibrant colors.
Mm-hmm.
But the first thing that we're going to have to do is put in our base color paints. And then we're going to add our neons to it. I'm painting on a 16 by 20 canvas. I get these economy packs. They're okay. They're all right. They're really easy on my pocketbook, and I like that. But sometimes I got to fight with the canvas a little bit. You know, you can miss these. You can, like, put, like, a little moisture on these, like, brush a little water on them. Don't soak them. Just, like, a light, like, moisture.
Mm-hmm.
I've noticed that if you mix a flow aid and then just lightly brush it on, that really helps. You know? Or just paint straight what I'm going to do.
Oh, yeah?
Guess what?
What?
Guess what?
What?
You want to see the palette?
I do. But you know what? Everybody really wants to see that shirt you're wearing. Actually, there's a lot of... Oh, that's your Follow Your Art shirt, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And I'd like to say this is a 2X, and it looks a little big on me, so I'm sort of excited.
Yeah?
Healthy life
choices. Has Diet Demon been helping? I see Diet Demon over there in the corner.
Diet Demon helps me
every
day.
Has he been helping you?
Yeah, we're going to paint Diet Demon at some point.
What do we have on the palette there? Oh, you can get that shirt in the store.
Yeah,
it's store,
the store.
Store.sherpa. Is it store.theartsherpa.com?
Store.theartsherpa.com.
Okay, there you go. We've plugged our shirt. Go.
I think it's in the description below.
Yeah, it is.
As are these materials, where I like to hide them. So I have some cadmium yellow medium. Now, if you want to save money on your paint, you can absolutely get hue. And if you have, you know, allergies, you might want to. Quinacridone magenta. Phthalo blue. I have two plops of this acrylic retarder by Grumbacher and titanium white. And on the magenta, guys, and even on the yellow, you could probably switch this yellow if you didn't have the cadmium to a Hansa. And you can probably do any fun magenta. And then I also have Mars black for the silhouette. And I have all the neon colors, all of them, but we're going to be putting them out later. Woo! Put this over as my reference. In description... is mm-hmm. a link to the full painting, more art materials, stores, links, all that stuff. I did wishes today.
Yeah,
John, I did.
Tell me about your wishes.
I'm just going to spin around and be like, what am I doing?
I see the wishes. I had RoboCam zoom in there on them a little bit.
Oh, did you? All right. So Terry is in a burn recovery ward, and we really wish for her to heal. She had a really unbelievable thing happen to her, and it's just our wish and hope that she heals. And Allison, she's just wanting to have a little more time with her grandma.
Yeah.
Just a little more. Linda needs some kidney health sent to her.
Mm-hmm.
Trisha would like some good positive home energy.
Yep.
And then I personally wish that this is a painting that helps and delights people. And I said I was grateful for John, who always has blind faith in what we're doing. So that is what I put into my canvas. Those are the words and thoughts and feelings. Oh, and John snuck one in too. I love my wife and family and my community. Thank you. He always sneaks one in his teeny tiny little writing. So I write these wishes on with like watercolor pencils, just the same way that I might sketch in a painting. So it sort of disperses into the paint. You don't have to do that, but I really love it. And if you see a wish in the live event that we didn't catch here, but that really inspires you, you can put it on your canvas and be a light keeper in the world, I'm going to use this 5/4 inch brush. Mm-hmm. This is not dissimilar to, it's the by the Maestro series, but it's not dissimilar to a house painting brush. It has a natural bristle. Interesting thing about natural bristles, John.
Yeah.
Well, besides the fact that they come from actual animals, they soften a little bit when they're wet. So sometimes when you're looking at them in the store thinking, oh, this might be great for acrylic, it may soften up quite a lot once the moisture gets in it.
Oh, yeah.
Things you might not know. The more you know.
So, now, what? Oh, no, go ahead. I have an anecdotally funny thing.
You have an anecdotally funny thing?
Yeah.
I have a painting funny thing.
Okay, you tell me a painting thing first.
Well, I'm going to take a little, just, you see how it's just on this little corner edge here?
Yeah, that's a cool brush you got there.
It is. I know. I'm kind of into it.
What is that?
This is just a 2-inch natural bristle brush by Maestro, 5/4 inch wide. You can get a lot of these. This has a pretty stiff spring.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to add a little blending medium to here. And I'm going to start at the bottom with this light yellow. And I have a really cool reason why.
Okay. Tell me your reason why, oh Sherpa.
I'm going to pretend like it's really cool, but it's just an art reason.
Okay.
Which is that what happens to a lot of people is their sunsets can get a little dark on them.
Uh-huh.
And a little muddy. And that's because of the way contrasting colors mix together.
Mm-hmm.
And their brush gets dirty and their water gets dirty. So by the time they get down to the yellow, bright area of their canvas,
yeah,
everything starts to get dark and muddy. So I thought for this one to help people have a better time getting bright colors, we'd start with the yellow and work up.
Oh, yeah. That would make sense.
It would make sense, right? Let's find out if that's true.
I've not seen you use a brush like that before here.
So. I have not. Look at this. Isn't this cool?
It's very neat.
So what is nice about, you know, these house type brushes, these big flat wides, is they give you these wide blending strip. See how nice that makes the blending?
It is. If you lean to your right, just I want to link over your shoulder. Oh, yeah. So you can definitely see how it blends that out. And I'll zoom in even tighter on there.
As I'm coming up, I'm adding a little more yellow pigment to the mixture.
Yeah, I see.
I am using the blending medium because I want the paint to stay a little bit wetter for longer so I can do this. See, I'm coming back down and softening.
Mm-hmm.
Having a little bob moment here, right? Softening it and get those nice stratas. And it's very soft. And so when I have taken the yellow, I'm going to take the yellow up one more inch.
This is one more inch, John. This is different than a house brush, though.
This is different than a house brush. I suspect you could probably pull this off with one, though.
Yeah.
I'm going to test that out.
Oh, there you go.
Because I've done some mural painting using house brushes, I'm going to say I really think you could.
Yeah?
Yeah. Hmm. All right. So we've gotten up to here. Now I'm going to take my quinacridone into my yellow. Add a little blending medium to it. And I'm going to blend the yellow edge with this orange edge.
So I want to say thank you to our huge community we've got out here. We've got almost 200 people here in the room with us hanging out.
Huge community.
We've got over 100 likes on our video so far.
100 likes.
Yeah, thank you, guys.
I so appreciate the likes. I love it when we hit Sherpa attendance or likes.
When we get to make the Sherpa dance, and that's when we hit 300 who are viewing or 300 likes in a video, we make the Sherpa dance. And actually, on that note, ha ha ha, I can't help but dropping a pun.
See, I'm pulling this color down into the blending medium.
Yeah.
That lets me blend it. Create that really cool desert sunset sky.
Oh, yeah.
I just wanted to share that.
No,
I think
it's really good. It is. I like how it blends together. I like, you know,
This is just another way to get it done. I like, you know, I'm always saying there's not just one right way in art. There's a lot of ways.
Yeah.
Every once in a while, I like to introduce some other ways. I'm going to just keep grabbing more and more of this magenta.
Mm.
Now, the magenta, the quinacridone magenta, is a translucent paint. So one of the things that happens to people as they're painting is some of their paints are opaque. Some of them are translucent.
Oh, yeah?
And so sometimes they'll be painting, they're like, why is everything showing through, right? And they're like, there's something crazy with the paint, but really what it is that the paint color is maybe a more translucent color.
I see.
So if you were to look at, say, phthalo blue versus cad yellow versus quinacridone magenta on these tubes, you can see what paint is more opaque.
Oh, yeah.
And then if you get to black, this paint is the most opaque. Look how opaque it is. You can't even see the lines.
Now, actually, one of the things that I thought was really kind of cool about Golden is they actually make labels that have them on there, too.
Yeah.
So you can see the labels in the store.
So you always know exactly. That's one of, yeah, it is absolutely a feature for me in this paint company, is their transparency. About transparency. I did. I was that silly. So now I'm here. I've got this nice sort of red.
Yep.
Maybe I want to pull a little bit more down here into my yellow, give it more of that deserty go. See how you can do?
Yeah.
This will be fine later.
Oh,
I just want to leave some yellow to be peeking up. And I'm going to take a little of this magenta over to my phthalo blue. And then my phthalo blue back over my magenta. But notice I'm not working the middle of the paint pops or mixing them together.
Mm-hmm.
That's because if I do that, right, I'm going to lose all my mixability. The other thing I'm going to avoid like a crazy person is this yellow.
Huh.
Because yellow and purple are contrast, and when they get together, they make
gray.
Gray, which is one of the things that grays out
I actually
people's sunset paintings.
Oh, Little Brush Addison wants to say hello. And you know what? On the note of the Little Brush Addison, I want to just say hello to the entire continent of Australia and all of the wonderful people out there who are hanging out with us, because we have a huge Australian viewership, which I think is kind of awesome. And I'm really getting into...
I think we have to say hello to a Sharon, too.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I think so.
Hi.
Hi.
And, you know, it's really cool because I'm getting into like High Chaparral and spaghetti westerns and, you know, sort of the Australian outback stories and Sweden as well. Just sort of loving all of the
he is
the really
it's true
coolness of all of that. So
I'm going to put out some more retarding medium. I'm sorry to be talking over you, babe, but
no,
I got to get
not.
Everybody through this blend real fast.
You just go right ahead. I'm just saying hi to all of our Australians.
I know. I just, you know, don't want to be like... See, when I add a little white to this, you can see how purple it is. I'm going to add a little blue in that. And add this purple band to start blending in the blue and the white that I've added to the brush. And definitely pull the little blending medium in to help me.
Now, see, that seems to be getting white there at the top.
Very Look at light. That.
Yeah.
I don't know if everyone can see this real well.
We're pretty zoomed in on it.
Huh?
We're pretty zoomed in on it.
Oh, cool. So one of the things I'm hoping you guys are noticing is the effect this wide brush is giving me.
Mm-hmm.
Right? We kind of feel that effect?
Yeah.
So this is another really fun way to get one of these ombre skies in. And I'm not rinsing my brush out, you might notice.
So there's a really interesting question here.
I have a really interesting answer. I answer all the questions.
And so it's about titanium white. Okay.
Yes.
So she says she's been Miss Pageant says that she's been ripping her hair out trying to figure out her titanium white. It's either too thick to work with.
Uh-huh.
Or she tries it in medium and it's too slick to use. So it's either like painting with glue. She feels like it's been painting with glue.
What's her brand?
Hmm.
That would be my next question. What brand of paint are we working?
So that could...
What brand of titanium white are you working?
Hmm. There we go. We'll find that out.
Yeah. That would be my follow-up question, because I think if I have that information, I can help solve that.
And Dominique is asking which brush that is. She missed it again.
Oh, this is a 5/4 inch wide. So it's not as thick as a house brush, if you look. It's a little thinner. And on an art brush, the difference between an art brush and a house brush is in this ferrule and how the brush is put together.
Mm-hmm.
So, length of the bristles, like a house brush will tend to run a longer bristle like this. The bristles have been shortened, which gives you stiffness and spring. They're very tightly packed here. And so that tends to let them go to an edge. So it looks like a house brush. And you can find versions of these brushes in your art stores.
Now, can they be using glazing medium instead of blending medium?
Yeah, the difference between glazing medium and blending medium is, well, actually, there's a bunch of things going on with the mediums. So there's two types of glazing medium. There is the Liquitex glazing medium, which creates translucent thin coats, right? So you can just stain things, and it dries very quickly. And then there's golden glazing medium, which is actually a retarder and a glaze.
Mm.
So that slows down the drying of your paint. So if you were expecting it to dry fast, that would totally mess with you.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you're expecting it to dry slow, that would totally mess with you. And then retarding medium, what that does is that slows the process of paint drying. And the thing you have to be careful about with retarding medium is using too much retarder to paint, because then your painting might not ever dry.
Gotcha.
But I really like the Grumbacher. That so far has been the one that I just will reach for at the moment. It's the one making me happy in my studio. And I'm very studio fickle in that I stick with what makes me happy.
Yeah. So we're going to say hi to Dubai.
Hi to Dubai. And I want to say hi to Sharon. Did we say hi to Sharon?
Hi, Sharon. You've been said hello to. How are you? Is there anyone else we want to make sure we say?
Even our adults.
We do. We have lots of people out here today. I think what it is that we want to make sure that we give you guys lots of shout outs and hugs and make sure that, you know, we love you guys. So
it's not just little brush shout outs.
It's just oftentimes we get, I'm also pacing with Cinnamon. So she's a fast painter.
I was real slow on this, but it's okay.
Well, you were goofing off there a little bit.
I was goofing off there a little bit. Probably should have done this about 3 minutes. But now you see this really, isn't it dramatic?
Uh-huh.
It's pretty dramatic.
It is.
This pretty dramatic sunset.
There's some drama on the canvas.
I'm going to really upset y'all by wasting paint.
Oh, no. How are you going to do that?
Well, because I don't really need this anymore, and I'm going to fold this over and make a butterfly.
Oh, no.
No, I've been having a plan about this lately.
Okay.
You kind of inspired the plan. So I've been making these butterflies with my palettes.
Uh-huh.
And I don't know. Somebody might get shipped them. Another YouTuber might get shipped them for a crafting challenge. I haven't really decided yet.
These might be components for future skins?
No, I wouldn't use these for skins.
No?
No, not for gel skins. But look at that.
Oh, that is cool.
Right? So, woo, that's ready.
Ah.
You know, it's when you get old palette paper, make lemonade. I don't know what that even means. Dry!
It's a Sherpa-ism.
It's a Sherpa-ism that we just made up right now. So I'm going to pull out my neon paint, but we're not going to be switching over to blacklight.
No.
Just yet.
No?
No.
No, you say?
No.
I don't believe.
Okay. I got to shake this up. It's coagulated or something.
It's a Sherpa shake.
So I've got some red here and some magenta. I've got some floral orange. I don't want that artist loft stuff. I've got some...
Run, Ian, run.
I don't think I'm going to do Lucas green on this one, but I do think I definitely want some blue. And, you know, it's always good to have floral white if you can get it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and yellow. So this is my little neon kit. You know, you can see here. Oh, and I've got some golden too. So I've got goldens, I think, is the most pigmented. I've got this fluid golden, but I'm going to use this run of them. So I've got Lucas here and Matisse Derivan.
Okay.
Guess what, though?
What?
Everybody has a line of fluorescent paints, and I literally mean everybody. Everybody. Liquitex has a line of fluorescent paints. Artist Loft has a line of fluorescent paints. Golden has a line of fluorescent paints. All those craft tubes have a line of fluorescent paints. Almost every paint company I know, because what you might not know is painting with neon colors is the rage right now. Positive is about neons. They give you color you cannot believe, and from a good company will hold the longest. Negatives is none of them are archival. They're not light fast. They're not forever. You can extend the life of your work a great deal if you put a good UV varnish over it.
Mm, yeah.
Of course, then it doesn't blacklight anymore because it's got a UV filter. So it does diminish the blacklight. My feeling on this in the collector world is like I think that the products are getting better, especially in the pro lines, for a more permanent thing. But even the best of the best, the paint manufacturers, are still saying not archival, not permanent. Now, they might be saying, like, it's good for 5 years, it's good for 10 years, it's good for, you know, a certain other number of years. But what they mean is, like, in 500 years, they're not really sure what state the fluorescent pink is going to be in.
Mm-hmm.
However, for the purposes of you sitting at this painting and putting it on your wall for the next couple of years with a little glow light on it, perfect. Does that make sense? I know I was on a rant there.
No, it's totally good. I appreciate that. That helps us out a lot.
And this just exploded at me.
Oh, yay.
Yay. But not on the shirt. Don't worry. Look.
So while you're putting the paint out.
Yep.
And you must not step on the soapbox. But you may.
I won't step on the soapbox. What am I? What did I do?
you didn't do anything. So Charlena, I'm going to go back up here because I read that from very far away. I want to make sure it's. Oh, my gosh. It's one of those names I'm going to do horrible at. Charlena says, I've got a speech to make in front of the mayor and loads of other people about the YMCA charity that she's working on. Mm-hmm. And she's really nervous.
Okay.
Do you have any advice for her and her stage frightness?
Yeah. Actually, I used to do Toastmasters and stuff like that.
So put the paint out.
Okay. Sorry. Don't. So put the paint out. Just stand there and freeze. you know... As someone who has like a fear of heights, I really understand and sympathize with a fear of public speaking. John, you have a fear of public speaking.
Mm-hmm.
That's really quite profound.
Yep.
Very difficult to deal with. I really think that visualizing and practicing in the mirror and doing those sort of like Anthony Robbins, if you're not familiar with those speaking techniques,
yeah,
about like you visualize the experience and you see yourself, you tell that story again and again and again of you're successful and you use those meditative techniques to calm down.
Mm-hmm.
I think those are, for me, have been the most helpful.
Yeah.
You know, and again, John, I mean, you wouldn't think it, but he is really actually quite shy.
Yeah. Preparation was the key for me.
Yeah.
If I knew I had things to say and stuff to fall back on, even if I flubbed something, that gave me the most comfort going out there. Because I was always afraid of just getting out and being like, I don't know what to say. Like whenever she just turns on the dryer and leaves me here abandoned with nothing to say or do, except go, my kid told me a knock-knock joke. How about I tell you that? That's good, right? So I totally get that. Okay. Sherpa.
John is really a champ for this. And I just want to say that I believe in you and I think that you can do it. All right, neon. So
neons.
I've got my pretty fun palette here out. All right. I'm going to just warm up my brush by just putting a little moisture on it, but I don't want it wet.
Okay.
And I'm going to start out maybe with my yellow. You see my nice, wonderful fluorescent yellow?
Yeah.
And my floral white. Titanium white is different than floral white. And I hope the camera can pick up this suddenly highly pigmented white and yellow mixture that I'm putting here.
You know, the wide camera has a little harder time doing it. The close-up camera will see, I can see that a little better.
Well, this second layer of paint, now, fluorescent paints are incredibly glazy.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you see right through them. They do not have pigment that carries. So that's why having a painting underneath
mm-hmm.
is the key to successful fluorescent painting.
Gotcha.
When you're starting out. There's some other tricks you can do. There's always other tricks, right? But this is what's going to really help you. I think I'm going to get into my red here, maybe, and a little of my yellow. Maybe pick up some of my orange. You can mix fluorescent paints. Look at that go up.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to maybe let some of this pull down into the wet paint. I'm not using blending medium here, and it's not really needed. These are very soft-bodied. Even the heavy-bodied fluorescents are still soft-bodied.
Really?
Yeah. I'm going to pull some just straight red into this, and you'll see that it's just very different. And I'm going to enjoy just building up this sunset with these intensely vibrant colors. In Kingman, Arizona.
Oh, yeah. That's an awesome place. We saw this.
Yeah. Yeah. I took pictures.
You did a selfie with it, too.
I did a selfie with it. The colors are more saturated than you can imagine.
That's crazy.
It is. It's just spectacular.
The camera couldn't even capture it. Two, two, two. Yay. I love seeing that.
Two, two, two.
We have our two,
it's
two,
almost
two
almost a dance. You can come back like when your brush is loaded with pigment like mine is.
Uh-huh.
And you can come down and make even a little blend here. There's just no end to the fun you can have.
Now, you don't need to do neon paints, do you, if you don't have them?
No, you could have just been done already.
Okay.
If you don't have neon paints, you're already done. but we've just talked a lot about how do neon paints actually work.
Uh-huh.
You know, in art, like outside of the black light. There's just been a lot of questions. I'm going to rinse my brush out now because I've got too much yellow and I'm getting up over my blue.
Ah.
And I don't want my yellow to go into this purple and blue. But I might take a little blue and pink and come right here. Can you see how the blue toned the pink a little bit?
Oh, yeah.
So neon paints, they absolutely mix. They do some really delightful stuff. I think one of the best evenings I ever had was hanging with my girlfriend Claire Stuckey, making color charts in black light for neon paints because we just gotten the full collection of them.
Uh-huh.
And we had bought like every kind that there was at Michael's in Hobby Lobby and the local art store. And we were like doing testing.
So Ian would like to know if this is the kind of scene that Kevin might visit.
I don't know if Kevin is going to visit this desert scenario.
it might be a little too high a chaparral for him.
I feel like there's a steampunk version of Kevin in the world. I just haven't resolved him yet.
You know, I think that I could see him, you know, in a steampunk cantankerous device out there. Definitely in some snow. I could see him in snow for sure.
Now, the wonderful thing by putting this other acrylic paint behind my neon is I have extended the life of my painting. So if you're hitting the craft circuit, like many of you are, and you're starting to catch on to the neon trend, as many of you are, this is a good way to, you know, always let your collectors know, but this is a good way to extend the life of their art, is to have the layer of paint behind it.
Interesting. That's good to know.
Just something you can do.
Oh, yeah.
For your collectors.
Steampunk Kevin's a big hit. They would like to see that.
Steampunk what?
Steampunk Kevin.
Steampunk Kevin. Yeah, I just think that's got to come up at some point.
I think he has to be on a train. But
I imagine he's going to come visit us on Turner's Lighthouse Day.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
So I'm just coming here. Now, the really wonderful thing is that, you know, even when you mix, like, colors that shouldn't be friends, like green and orange in neon, they still do some cool stuff. So you never have to, like, ever be worried about that. So there that is, right? And that's sort of fun. Isn't this lovely on my brush? I think this is the happiest paint to use.
That's a really cool brush looking.
It's just really cool.
So don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share.
Let's get to 300.
Oops. Doop.
I was going to dance, but you don't get a dance yet because it's not that.
I got enthusiastic because I was like, hey, whack. So hit the little like button. We're trying to get that to 300. That's a really important one for us. We love to see that get up there.
The first day that I get a 300 like on a video, 300 people during the live and like a 300 sub uptake, I'm going to design a new shirt called We Are Sherpa.
Oh, yes. That will definitely be out.
I may still design it anyway. Don't even have anxiety over that. Because I just want to make it. I'm going to draw this and give John that panic attack he mentioned earlier.
Just doing it. See, no, I sabotage you. Haha, you're not plugged in.
I am not plugged in. Bye, I'm coming off camera now.
Oh, gosh. There she goes.
We're professional.
Sherpa down.
We're so professional that I exit camera.
I don't even know where she went now. She's just unplugged and gone. Nope, she's back. Okay. Hi, guys. Like, comment, subscribe, share. Hit the thumbs up. We really like that stuff. Gosh, thank you guys for all coming out and hanging out with us. I see all the people in the room, all of our wonderful moderators. I see Emmy the Mastermind. All of our little brushes and all of our friends. It's so good to see you guys. Oh, yeah, and I was going to tell you about notes. I said on that note the other day, earlier, we have new music coming. Yay for new music. And as soon as the Sherpa pushes her button, you have to push a button.
Do we all assess that looks pretty good?
Yeah, I think so. I was just telling them that this is the last time they have to, well, maybe not the last time, because we may come back for it for old time's sake later. But this will be the last time that I use this music in our live. We're going to, for a while, because I'm going to be rotating it out.
Oh, I didn't know you were, I don't know. See, John's in charge of music.
We're going to go from our...
I'm going to use my number 10 Bright, also known as Goldilocks by Simply Simmons.
Uh-huh.
Firm Filament.
They like that brush holder, by the way.
Oh, they should. I like this brush holder.
Pretty
Did
neat.
They notice?
Yeah. Becky, I think, noticed. I saw it. There's been a couple. And Kim Sim just said, can we see the new brush holder? That was a nice gift, wasn't it? brush guys and say thank you to the brush guys and Rich and Richardson.
You really, really, really nice. Need to be stalking the channel this week because there's some all the videos from the YouTube space
are coming.
When we were there at VidCon, if you guys remember, are being approved.
The
now.
Brushes are coming. The brushes are coming.
And so there's a whole series of videos coming.
You'll have fun with.
So you got to watch the channel this week. Watch it.
So what? So, all right.
All right. I'm going to do this.
But I'm changing my music. That's what I was saying.
Yeah, you're changing your music. I'm grabbing a little of my black. Now, I'm going to do a cheeky thing here. I'm going to get a little red.
What you got?
See this weird little red?
Uh-huh.
I'm going to put that in my black paint. How weird is that? And I'm going to come up about 3.5 inches on mm-hmm. the right-hand side, planting my bristles firmly on their tip or edge. And I'm going to take a nice little hill that goes gradually down here.
It's almost like you were describing a martial arts move there.
It is. It's all Mr. Miyagi all the time. And what you're going to want to look for, and hopefully you're seeing in here, so you know yours is like mine, is you want this paint to be thin enough that some of the yellow is shining through. Because as you do the brush strokes, it'll make landscape for you.
Mm-hmm.
And whenever you don't have to work harder, it's a good thing.
Agreed.
Agreed. And it's almost like a brown. This neon red and this black made kind of a lovely brown. Because these hills are going to be further away. Now wipe your brush. And just get some pure black.
So, now if you put a UV protectant over this.
Yes.
Will it make it last longer?
Yes. It won't be as photoreactive in black light.
Mm.
We'll show a test of that sometime. But it will last longer.
So, it cuts down on the amount of UV that comes through, being that
thus
black light is ultraviolet.
Slows down the fading of your neon paint. I'm going to hit this real quick.
That makes sense. It, you know, the whole... So yeah, UV does deteriorate your paint faster, but it is also what makes it glow. So there you go. You have
there
to.
There you go. I'll tell you, the artist lofts in the tubes have faded out on me on 6 months.
Yeah.
Where I lost the pigment in the tube at 6 months. So, but I've never seen a fade on the Lucas or Dervan, and I've had them for more than a year.
So if everyone's asking, where did you get the wonderful brush holder? And we'll say, you have to go to the brush guys and bug them.
Yeah, this
and
was,
they have a coupon code that you can use over there to get 5% off the Art Sherpa, but I don't know.
I don't think that they sell these there. I think these are a display thing that they brought. When you see the video, you will see.
They brought the display and we just sort of.
And I was just like, that's what I want more than anything in the universe. I think it was like my birthday during that week. So Jeff Morrow was feeling. And Richardson sent it? Or
yeah,
the brush guy
well,
sent
you know,
it.
I think it came from Richardson,
yeah.
But I think that Jeff facilitated that.
I think so. And I've really enjoyed Richardson. I actually have.
Yeah,
but
they've
you,
been very
you guys
nice.
Will see why as the week develops. You got to watch the channel. All right, so I've come up about not as high as I did on this side.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to make a little kind of scoopy valley. Do you remember how when we were driving 66, it would like valley down and we go, wee,
oh,
wee.
Yeah.
Kind of like that. Down from the top here, I want this hill to peek out. Because I want layers.
Layers.
I'm just going to paint that all in black. This is going to be the easiest, fastest moment in the whole painting. Painting it in black.
Oh, see, the brush guy, and everyone was asking for the coupon code for the brush guys is TheArtSherpa. So you just type in all one word, TheArtSherpa, I think, and that'll activate your 5% off there.
So, you know, having some good times here.
Mm-hmm.
Having some good times here. But, oh, by the way, don't worry if the brush guys are not in your area. They do ship worldwide, and if the shipping is too high, a lot of these products are available globally.
Yeah, we try to do our best to work with all of the
yeah,
our friendly people.
We're not sponsored, so we just have freedoms.
Actually, you know, at this point, I feel it's like we're definitely not sponsored, but Cinnamon pilfers an awful lot from Jeff.
I do?
You do. He's like, ooh, that's pretty. I'll take one of those.
Okay, yeah. I maybe claim salvage when we're at sea, but you will also see that.
Any brush that is left adrift for more than, you know, an arm's length is
if
claimed.
You don't guard charge your cool brushes, I will claim them. That is, my mom knows that. She could have told him.
That's where
you're watch your brushes around that girl. She'll take them.
Now, how, what is the size? What is the width of that one you were using earlier?
That's a number 10 bright.
No. The gray one that you use for the background.
Oh, it's 5/4 inch.
Is it? It's here, 5.
I will soak get the water out of it because it's all soaking now.
It's bigger than an inch. It's wider than an inch.
It says 5/4 inch. This thing.
Inch and 5/4? 5/4? I don't know. It says that on a...
That's what it says.
Interesting. All right.
I have no idea.
It's almost an inch.
It's almost an inch. I really feel like it's bigger than that. I feel like it's almost 2 inches.
Yeah, me too.
That's my feeling. I'm not responsible for the crazy brush company.
Yeah.
I'm going to continue doing brush safaris to show you guys just how to buy brushes.
Mm-hmm.
So you're not brand dependent. So I'm going to go places like you watch the Facebook for the live events. I might be in a Walmart brush shopping and art material shopping saying what I would buy from there.
Yeah.
So I'm going to start over here on my left, and I'm going to start on my saguaro.
Okay. On your what?
My cactus.
Oh, yeah.
So the first thing about doing these wonderful cactuses, and I think we've all loved them since we were a kid, is trying to get a fairly, and this is my challenge, is a fairly vertical line. Ooh. And I'm going to come up to, how tall is this?
Gosh,
I'm
going to
come up maybe into this little purple. So it's almost to the halfway mark, but not quite. And I may need to switch to a smaller brush. I might. I don't think this brush is going to give me the control I want. So as much as I like it, it's going to go in timeout. And I'm going to pull out a...
What is it?
I don't know. Number 6 Filbert.
Number 6 Cat's Tongue.
Or this number 8 short handle. I'm going to work with these two.
All right.
I just want a little more control.
More control.
More control over what's happening here. So I'm going to, because what you want is a fairly parallel, evenly thick little finger sticking right up into the sky. It's kind of what you want, weirdly enough. Now, you may find with your black, this happens to a lot of people because their black isn't that pigmented, that it's not covering what's underneath. That just means dry it and give it 2 coats. Either upgrade your black or dry it and give it 2 coats.
Well, Emily just joined us.
Hi, Emily.
And she said that she just finished painting the Luminary Lion.
Oh, and she that's a challenge, man. Congratulations to you for doing him. It's not quick.
Yeah.
Wasn't a quick paint on YouTube, and it isn't a quick do at home, but it is worth it. I love the results you guys get when you guys do him. So I'm just trying to create this finger. That's my goal. See how I'm widening slowly?
I do.
Right? And I kind of sketch out.
Yeah.
If I made a mistake... I'll show you how I'd repair a mistake.
Okay.
I'm going to do a mistake over here.
Oh, no.
I made a mistake. Okay, so I'll show you guys in a minute how I would fix that as I get over there, because obviously I don't want to leave that.
All right.
That's yucky. All right. So I feel like I have a fairly good finger sticking out of the desert.
Yeah.
And the fun, I love, this is my favorite thing. So I'm going to bring a little arm, and he's going to come out straight a little bit. But then he's going to start curving up. He's going to turn. And he's not going to be quite as tall as his friend. Maybe a woodpecker lives in this one. The other horrible thing that can live in these is giant swarms of tarantulas, by the way. Don't ever take one of these from the desert and replant it at your house.
Interesting to know.
Oh. had you know, live in California. Californians do kind of what Californians do. And someone we know did that. They found a, you know, because these things are like thousands of dollars at the nursery.
Mm-hmm.
You know why they're thousands of dollars at the nursery? Because they're tarantula free. And that's what you would pay for a cactus that wasn't going to release hundreds of thousands of baby tarantulas in your house.
That's a good thing.
That's what you're really paying for.
Yes.
Tarantula free. Just little facts that you might not know. Now you're going to be like in the desert going, is this one a tarantula? All right, I'm gonna do another little arm down here closer to the ground. Going to go out, but he's going to make that turn too, and he's going to be shorter. you can decide if your cactus here is a tarantula-free version, or if you're maybe a little darker and more macabre. Maybe they're all tarantula cactuses. I don't know. It's your desert. Put in it what you want. Maybe there's a chupacabra. He's eating goats over that hill. Just eating them.
So
I don't know. I'm in a weird mood today.
A couple of people say that Rex Art has this brush holder.
Do they?
Yeah. So they and the brush guys don't have it apparently for sale on their site, so it probably was a promotional or some sort of special thing. But word is from the Sherpettes that Rex Art.
Trust the Sherpettes, man. They find stuff that nobody else finds. And I'm bringing another little arm right here. Love his little arm.
We have like 215 likes and over 230 people in here. It's been really awesome. Thank you, guys. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up, the like, the comment, to share. That lets everyone know that you guys were here and you like what you saw.
Also, it helps us with the YouTube.
With the YouTube. That's right.
He's sitting there. He's feeling very proud. I've got a little orange on him.
And when we get to 300 likes, we make or 300 people in the room, we make the Sherpa dance.
Yes.
And I have new dance music I'm working on so that we can. I might even put some disco lights in here.
You really should.
make it turn into a full disco.
Well, just because we paint in here with the kids a lot with the black lights on, because that's their favorite thing. If it isn't your favorite thing, it's just because you haven't gone to Home Depot and bought the bulb. All right. I'm going to fix this hot mess over here.
Oh, no. How did that happen?
I don't know how
what it happened. How did that happen? How I'm did you so get black paint on your it. Canvas? It was the children.
Well, that's happened more than once with me. First, I'm going to take a little white and paint it out. I don't need to totally erase it. I just need to lighten it enough where what comes next will have enough pigment to deal with it.
Wow. There's some sticker shock on that brush holder out there.
It's a good gift, right?
It was. Thank you, guys. Apparently, that was a really nice gift. So, can you lean over just a second so we can see?
I'm still working it. So, what the issue is with the paint, and I may need to get some of the quinacridone.
Oh yeah.
Is I've got to get enough pigment over the black. So the white, as you can see, wasn't even enough. Because I wiped it back up.
Mm-hmm.
It's okay. If you don't like a repair, guess what you can do?
What? Oh, you wipe?
Yeah, you can.
Yeah.
You can totally wipe. It's allowed. Just now, don't panic.
Now, that there's a lot of chatting about the...
There we go. It's gone now. All right. So I got to dry that. Sorry, John.
Oh, no, it's just your little fluffy hair is just in the way of the... There it goes. So, yeah, for you guys, that brush holder is built like a tank.
It is.
So, if you're quite, it is super high quality. It's got a little water holder in it, too. It's really nice. So
I'm just putting the quinacridone over the top. So, I'm just trying to repair this. So, I've got the quinacridone layer back.
And you heard the your YouTube hat fuzziness is
my hat fuzziness.
Your hat fuzziness is just a very obscuring, just a little tiniest bit.
All right, where can I move it?
You're fine.
I'll do this.
We're working around you.
All right, so here we go. I'm gonna start.
Oh my gosh, it just disappeared.
Patch. Yeah. Yep.
Zoom.
Just put some more, you know. Just come back in and make it part of your sunset. It's a feature, not a fault. It's an improvement. Maybe you make the prettiest spot of your sunset right now because you did this. I don't know. Just don't let the mistakes stop you. Mistakes happen in art. We all do them.
Yeah.
We all flub. And that's why it's great to be able to just come in and be like, oh, it's just a better sunset now. Look at this. It's awesome. So that's how I would fix that.
Yeah. It's just gone.
Yep. It just goes. It just goes away. I'm just gonna make it go all the way away. Go away. And it's a little bit darker here, so a thing that I can do is I can take my pink and my blue and pull a little of this purple down into that space, so then that makes sense.
Yeah.
In the atmosphere, see? Just keep working your repair.
Just keep painting.
And sometimes, yeah, just keep painting. That's literally always the solution. Just keep painting. Be the Dory of art.
Layers.
Just layers and hairdressers.
So if Shrek and Dory had a love child, it would be a painting. Just keep painting those layers.
Back to black. Back to black. Make another little vertical finger coming out of the desert.
As it rises up. There's, I mean, like, when you go back and look at desert, plants and things, it's really crazy reminiscent. I mean, like, it's prehistoric surface of the planet, you know?
Yeah, it's amazing, right?
Yeah, it's really cool to go out there and look at, like, these are some really tough plants that have been around for a long time, surviving that environment. And then there's some that have adapted very quickly, too. But it's just so cool to look at that.
Just enjoying putting my little finger in. Little finger. Not the Game of Thrones little finger. No. This is a good cactus. Not destined to have some horrible end. Possibly full of tarantulas.
Turtle, Dominique. Turtle, Dominique screams. Turtle!
Turtle what?
I don't know.
Turtles?
Oh, there's
I like
turtles
them.
Here.
Let's go, Dominic.
Craven
That's cool.
Turtle. Creatives in Turtle has just come in and is moving to Houston.
Oh, awesome.
Okay, cool. I had no idea. Well, to be closer to the Sherpa, you can come to some Sherpa get downs.
Yep. We're working on them. We are. Guys, the meetup in Michigan is not me coming to Michigan. It's about you guys getting together in Michigan to hang out with each other. I'm going to bring up another little arm right here. Though I might make a digital appearance for meetups.
See, I wasn't sure if Dominique was like playing Pokemon Go and was just screaming out that she saw turtles or something.
Yeah, well, you know.
That's the rage right now.
Somebody's going to get sued for that in a minute, screaming Pokemon.
Lots of people seem to have had pet turtles.
Well, turtles are awesome, and the most amazing turtle video in the world is coming. Or it's the worst. I don't know.
It's so turtly.
It's so turtly. If you like turtles, again, watch the channel because the stuff is starting to improve from the space.
It's true.
Whenever we make a video in the YouTube Next Up space and those spaces, they have to view it and approve it. So that's something you might not know. See, I made another little. This is a happy little cactus friend. Guess what else lives in the desert? Weird little sticky things. So we should probably put some of those out there. Right? And those, obviously there's prickly pears. So when I do a prickly pear, I usually bring a line up.
Mm-hmm.
And then I try to remember like little circle shapes. Make one there. Lots of ellipses and ovals is what I find helps me get my prickly pears. Bring a little prickly pear up here. He can finish with a little oval. They're kind of teardroppy.
Are those the ones that I eat?
Do you eat prickly pears? When does that happen?
Because at the restaurant, they always have the...
Oh, yeah.
The
Not
cactus.
Not this part of it, but yeah.
And that's the... I always like having cactus.
See, I'm just making those little loops, and it feels like now there's one just sitting there in silhouette. Now I feel like this needs a little sticky up. Because there's always these weird little stickies out in the desert, isn't there? Coming up. I keep my pressure really light when I'm doing those. And I even let them fade in and out.
Let me see if you can lean over just to your... Oh, there we go. Perfect. Bang. Got him.
Some sort of grass there. We don't know what.
We don't know.
We don't know. We do know, but we don't know. We pretend like we don't know because we're cheeky like that. Maybe another little one happening here. Whoops, didn't push that back. Hope that didn't mess with the focus.
I think we're okay.
Another little one up here, and it twists. See how it went back?
Yeah.
It was cheeky. Right? If you need to go back and refine something, you can. I'll make some little distant shapes on the hill. And I'm going to make some more bushes coming along this hill. It's not perfect. Maybe there's rocks. Little scrumbly little rocks are always my favorite. I mean, you can have fun here. You could have little coyotes off on this little distant hill.
Oh,
you can just have a whole little thing.
We had a funny little thing. So True Blue just notified me that we're 16 likes away from making you do the Sherpa dance. And we should, because we're almost done with this painting.
Well, I mean, we kind of are, the other thing, I actually might put in some more sequoias, though.
Okay, so you put those in real quick, and
more plant styles. The other plant style I really like is this sort of like, it's like a twig, but it's a fluffy twig, so it comes up like that. This is another little shape. I looked at a bunch of these, like, what plants were in the desert? I took all these pictures of them. So I was like, I don't want to keep stopping. You know, and of course there was the road of endless living animals where they were like, hey, I know what, let's play in the road. All right, so we have that there.
Are
we close to our 300? Because I'd like do it when we go blacklight. Or maybe we need to go blacklight to get it. I don't know. What do you guys say?
I'm sorry. I misread that. We have 260 likes.
Oh, we're a minute away.
Oh, yeah, we're a minute away.
Do you want to show them what this looks like in blacklight?
I do want to read this.
You can add birds to the sky. You could put a little pueblo here. Or you could leave this just a really, really fun, interesting painting.
So you're going to have to go up here and look at camera 3.
I have to look at camera 3?
Well, if I'm going to flip into black light.
Which is camera 3?
Camera
3.
Is that 3? There's 3.
This is 3? That's 3. Well, I see nothing.
It did nothing?
Whoa. It literally did nothing. There it is. Now it can see.
Sort of.
There. Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Now it works.
Yeah, oh yeah, check it out.
And while you guys are checking out that camera, I'll adjust camera 1 so
you
that
kind of get a sense of how it gets different each time.
Yeah.
But is yet sort of similar. Is that not bananas? I swear, I put this up on Instagram, and it was like when you took it through the 3 stages of light, it looked like it was the sunset going to nighttime. Because you know how the desert kind of glows at night?
Yeah.
You can't even see me. Hello, I'm in the black light. Thumbs up.
You can go over to, we'll jump over to camera 1. You can see it over there too now a little bit.
No, you can't see it camera 1, can you? You can. Also, I want to say that I feel like black light is very youthening and is as effective as Botox for improving. I love the palette in the.
I'm going to get over and get that working too.
Isn't that really cool? That's fun. I love painting with this stuff, and you can, you know, when you have it in this sense, you can always go back. Like, when you switch over to a blacklight scenario, you can always, always, always come back and, you know, come back and say, hey, you know, I need a little more blue here, and work it then with the blacklight so it has the best presence in the blacklight that it could possibly have. So, look at that. All right, guys. I feel like we've really gone to every level of the desert.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to teach how to draw a realistic rose on Facebook Live tonight.
Oh, yeah?
You guys want to come for that? I'm going to do that.
Ooh, that would be kind of interesting.
Sunsets and sunrises, because we have the Lightkeeper series coming. Watch the channel for stuff dropping at weird times, weird hours from our trip to L.A. I love you very much, and I hope you're okay. I hope you're well. I hope you're safe. I hope you're catching all the Pokemon you could catch.
All of them.
This will make no sense in 5 years.
Catch them all.
You guys have a beautiful, beautiful day. I'll see you really soon.
Love you guys.
Bye-bye. Come join us live. Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday at 11 a.m. Central, or enjoy one of the hundreds of paintings available on replay anytime.